A very pleasant good evening to one and all. I'm R. Edward. I'm studying BBD first year in Dr. NJR Education Research Institute, Aegis Medical College and Hospital, Chennai. I'm very much happy and glad to participate in this event, which is organized by Regional Academy and Professional Institute Training Presence, this great End Physio Warriorship Contest. And I'm happy I'm just coming out of my box to participate in this event, and thank you for this great, great opportunity. In this oratorship contest, and I'm here to deliver my oratorship contest speech in the topic of sciatica. When come to the sciatica, I'm going to explain sciatica in a various forms. Before I'm just move into the sciatica topic, I just want everyone to clear one thing, that sciatica is not a disorder or disease, it is just a symptom. Okay, the sciatica, it is often which is referred to the low back pain and is often gradually moved to the leg. How the pain occurs, what is the cause of the pain? Majorly the sciatica will occur when there is a compression or some irritation of the sciatic nerve. Before we all know about the sciatica, we all must know about the sciatic nerve. What is sciatic nerve? Sciatic nerve is one of the widest and longest nerve in our body, and the nerve supply of a sciatic nerve, it's majorly 5 different nerve supply. They are L4, L5, S1, S2 and S3. These 5 nerve supply are supplied by the spinal column, and then these 5 nerve supply will reach to the sacrum and it results in the formation of sacral plexus. When come to the sacral plexus, these 5 different nerve supply will divide it into 2 different divisions. As they are known, they are anterior division and posterior division. When come to the anterior division, these L4, L5, S1, S2 nerve, except S3, will form a tibial nerve. When come to the posterior division, these L4, L5, S1, S2 will form the common peroneal nerve. Like these 2 nerve supply, like the tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve, which connects the connective tissue and form a sciatic nerve. Basically, this sciatic nerve has only 2 different branches, like a tibial nerve and a common peroneal nerve. And then, sciatica, we must have to know about the origin of a sciatic nerve. When come to the origin of a sciatic nerve, it is nothing but the piriformis muscles. It is the major origin of the sciatica. Basically, as we all know, the sciatic nerve has the 2 different branches, like tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve. Next, we have to know about the origin of a sciatic nerve. The origin of a sciatic nerve is nothing but the piriformis muscle. And this sciatic nerve will supply to the lower back of a thigh, the back of a thigh region. And these 2 branches, like the tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve, will supply different parts and the compartments of the leg. And now we are going to know about the part which is the both tibial nerve and the common peroneal nerve, it's where it is supplied. The first thing we are going to see about the tibial nerve. When come to the tibial nerve, it supplies majorly to the posterior compartment of the leg, and it is also supplied to the intrinsic flexors. And then we move on to the common peroneal nerve. When come to the common peroneal nerve, it supplies 2 major compartments, which includes anterior compartment and lateral compartment, and it also supplies to the intrinsic extensors. These are all the overview of sciatica and also about the sciatic nerve, and these are some of the introduction. And as we all know, I think we are very much clear now, because the sciatica is a symptom which is acquired due to the compression of a sciatic nerve, and hence the name is also arrived as a sciatica. And next we are going to see about the types. So in my in this explanation of a sciatica, I'm going to explain sciatica as I said before in a different use. The first thing we have seen about the introduction, and now we are going to see about the types of sciatica. When come to the types of sciatica, it divides into 2 different types. The first thing, it's about the neurogenic sciatica, and second thing, it's about the referred sciatica. When come to the neurogenic sciatica, this pain and this type which is often occurs when there is a compression or the some problems which related to the sciatic nerve and to the small nerve roots. And the, basically the symptoms can be vary from one person to the another person because it depends upon the variety or it may vary, depends upon the pressure on the sciatic nerve. This neurogenic sciatica will occur when there is a issues or the causes such as disc herniation or bulging of the intervertebral disc, or it may also due to some tight muscles. And next thing we are going to see about the referred sciatica. When come to this referred sciatica, it is acquired when there is a pain in the joints and the muscles or related to the pelvis and the spinal column. And basically this can mimic a sciatica, and the cause is very much important to know in this referred sciatica. Basically, due to or during this referred sciatica, it can also result certain problems such as loss of reflex or loss of sensations or objective weakness can also be present during this referred sciatica. So these are all which comes under the types of sciatica. As I clarified before, there is nothing about the neurologic sciatica and the referred sciatica. And next thing we are going to see about the causes of the sciatica. Come to the causes, it's mainly it's divided. Causes can be divided into two different things. One is about spinal causes and another thing about the non-spinal causes. First we are going to see about the spinal causes. As name indicates, this spinal causes is often related to the spinal column. The first thing we are going to see under this spinal causes, it's very much familiar to us, it's nothing but intervertebral disc herniation. This intervertebral disc is present in between the vertebra, and the major function of this intervertebral disc, it acts as a shock absorber. How this herniation will occur? After herniation occurs, it results in the bulging of intervertebral disc. And it also occurs when the nuclear macrophages, this nuclear macrophages like interleukin, it is also affect the intervertebral disc parts. So, as usual, it leads to the inflammations and swelling. So, these are the causes for intervertebral disc herniation. And second thing we are going to see about the spinal stenosis. How spinal stenosis is occurring? The spinal stenosis is nothing but the narrowing of intervertebral column, like nothing but intervertebral foramen. How it occurs? It occurs due to the degenerative bone conditions, or it may due to some trauma. And next thing we are going to see about the spondylolithosis. This spondylolithosis occurred when the vertebra get displaced. The displacement of the vertebra is occurred due to three reasons. The first thing is about degenerative bone condition, and second thing is about the surgery or the problems which occurs during surgery, or third thing is about the trauma. And next we are going to see about the sacroiliac joint disinfection. As we all know, this sacroiliac joint is present between the sacrum and the pelvis. When this sciatic nerve which passes in the sacroiliac joint for the excess toward the pelvis, if the damage occurs in the sciatica or in the joint, it may lead to the compression of a sciatic nerve. So as a result, it leads to the sacroiliac joint disinfection. It's one of a joint disinfection or destruction. And next thing we are going to see about the growth. The growth factor, as we all know, it's all about the cyst or abscesses which is growing in the intervertebral disc or the vertebral column, which is finally leads to the compression of a sciatic nerve. So these are all the topic which comes under the spinal causes. And next thing we are going to see about the non-spinal causes. The first thing in non-spinal causes we are going to see is very much familiar. Many people, the most risk factors in this disease is piriformis syndrome. How piriformis syndrome occurs? As I told before, the origin of the sciatic nerve is piriformis muscle. When these muscles get inflamed or muscular spasm occurred, the piriformis syndrome will result. Basically, this non-spinal causes which occur outside the vertebral column, and it will damage the sciatic nerve itself. Like when, as I told before, the muscular spasm or inflammation, so the pain to the piriformis muscle which occur, which directly lead to the compression or pain to the sciatic nerve. And these are the concept of the piriformis syndrome. When the piriformis syndrome, what are the risk factors? The persons who are affected by the piriformis syndrome can't able to sit or walk. They have some difficulty in walking and certain related problems. And next thing, it is also one of the familiar thing we are going to see about the valet sciatica. What is valet sciatica? As many men's or many people's are using or keeping the valet at the back of the packet, when the during sitting posture, this valet will produce some or which is put some pressure on the gluteus muscles. So due to this pressure, which leads to the compression of a sciatic nerve. So it is one of the causes. It's nothing about the valet sciatica. And the third thing we're going to see about the pregnancy. In pregnancy, the mother with a fetus, it occurs when during a sitting time. Because when it is sitting, occurs of sitting posture, the head of the fetus will put some pressure on the sciatic nerve. Because as we all know, the sciatic nerve is present very much close to the pelvic region, it's a pelvis. At this condition, which is causes the compression of a sciatic nerve. And the fourth thing is about the pelvic tumors or pelvic stenosis. But these are all the topic which comes under the non-spinal causes. So now I think you're very much know about the causes, as I said before, the spinal causes and non-spinal causes. And before we move on to the symptom, we must know about the risk factor. How the persons are very much prone to this disease. What are the major risk factors? Basically, this sciatica, which occurs around 40% of our population, the ages of occurred around 40 to 50 years of age of people will often have this symptom like a sciatica. What are the conditions when the sciatica will occur? We must have to know this. The first thing, the patients or those who are having diabetes disease, or they have a sedentary lifestyle, or the persons who employees working by lifting heavy objects, and it is also they have a low spinal movement and pre-existing spinal degeneration. Due to this all factors, it's very much prone to this disease. So these are all the very important conditions. If the persons have these conditions, they are very much risk and prone to this sciatica. And next thing, now we are going to see about the symptoms of sciatica. There's lots of symptoms of sciatica. The first thing is about the shooting or sharp pain in the leg. And next thing is about the weakness, difficulty in walking. The one who's affected with the sciatica can't able to lift the leg in the upward or forward direction. And numbness which often occurred. And sensation, loss of electrical sensation, some burning or prickling sensation in the legs. These are all the major symptoms that the person with sciatica will often experience. And how the pain will locate? Because we must have to know about the location of the pain. The first thing, outside of the calf, the foot, these are all the location of the pain. And next thing, we are going to see about the treatment. When it comes to the treatment, we must very much familiar to the treatment, that we all know that the treatment can be classified in two different things. The one is about the surgical treatment and another is about the non-surgical treatment. The first we are going to see about the non-surgical treatment. Okay, in non-surgical treatment, the first thing we are going to see about the Lasinger's sign. It's nothing but straight leg raise test. In the short form, we will say like SLR test. At this condition, the examiner will keep the person who is affecting the sciatica in a table and he will lift the leg upward and forward, like a knee will be stretched like this. At this condition, all the nerve roots can also be stretched. It is in the angle between 30 degree and 70 degree. At this condition, if the person feels very much pain or the compression in the nerve, the result is positive. At this condition, they must have to take a CT and MRI scanning very much needed. And second thing is about the pain. Basically, the sciatic pain will occur sometimes, it differs from person to person, as we all know. Sometimes the sciatic pain will occur gradually or suddenly. At this condition, the pain can be relieved by anti-inflammations or drugs or medications can be used. And apart from this, there's a lot of methods as we are practicing to prevent the sciatica. The first thing is about the massage therapy, exercise, or we can also use a heat or ice packs. and acupuncture, dry needling, and these are all the various factors we are using a non-surgical treatment. Next we move on to surgical treatment. Why this surgical treatment is required? Because when a non-surgical treatment is not completely satisfied, or the pain didn't remove, or the pain didn't move away, still the patient is suffering from the pain, at this condition only the surgical treatment is made. But it's a rare case only. How the surgical treatment will made? The first thing is the minor discectomy. At this condition, the pain, the bulging intervertebral disc will be removed off on the vertebral column, and then it can be able to prevent the compression sciatic nerve. And second thing is about the spinal fusion. The spinal fusions are rarely occurred when there is a high disc injuries. At this condition, the vertebra is present in between the intervertebral disc, that is a damaged intervertebral disc. At this condition, the spinal column, the vertebra will be fused off. So it can also be able to prevent the compression or irritation to the sciatic nerve. And third thing we are going to see about the disc replacement. As we all know, the replacement of the knee or hip, likewise, the artificial disc will be kept in between the vertebral column, and it will prevent the compression or the pain in the sciatic nerve. And these are all surgical treatment and the non-surgical treatment. And next thing we are going to see some of the important facts or important thing we must know about in sciatica. Basically, the sciatica which occur in two different conditions. The first thing is about unilateral, and second thing is about bilateral. As we all know, in unilateral condition, it occurs in a very single part of the limb. But when come to the bilateral condition, this rare condition which occurs only when during a central disc herniation, or it occurs when there is a lumbar stenosis or traumatic condition. Due to these three reasons, and it's also due to spondylolisthesis. Due to this all reason, bilateral condition will occur, but it is only a rare condition. And next thing, as we all know, this sciatic nerve supplied by 5 different nerve supply. In that compression or the pain in the S1 nerve supply will lead to ankle jerk reflex. But when come to L5 nerve supply, it will lead to the knee jerk reflex. So these are all the things we must know. And next thing we are going to see about the Cauda equina syndrome. The Cauda equina syndrome, it rarely occurred in the people because it's due to sciatica. When the person is affected with sciatica, sometimes it will lead to the Cauda equina syndrome. Why the name it occurs like a Cauda equina syndrome means the nerve bundles which is present at the base of the spinal cord, it look like a horse tail, and hence the name arises like a Cauda equina syndrome. At this condition, the patients will feel loss of bowel or loss of bladder control, or loss of experiencing the weakness in the movements of the legs. These are all symptoms which is occurred in the Cauda equina syndrome. At this condition, if a patient feels very much severe pain or the compression sciatic nerve, the surgery is very, very much needed. These are very much known. As I told before, that SLR test, that is straight leg rise test, is a neurodynamic test. It is one of the prominent tests or a prominent physical examination. It will take all over country for treating this sciatica. As we all know, sciatica is a very good symptom. And next thing, we are going to see about the clinical forms of sciatica. When it comes to the clinical forms of sciatica, it includes hemiphagic sciatica, paralytic sciatica, and myalgic sciatica. When it comes to the hemiphagic sciatica, it is a very, very severe case. At this condition, the patients must remain in the bed itself. They can't able to do their regular movements. And next thing, we are going to see about the myalgic sciatica. When it comes to the myalgic sciatica, the condition affected nerve is S1 nerve supply, and there is a mild motor deficit will happen during this myalgic sciatica. And third thing we are going to see about the paralytic sciatica. In this case of the paralytic sciatica, the affecting nerve supply is nothing about L5 nerve supply, and there is a slight motor deficit will occur in this case. And before we move on to summary, I like to talk about the topics and the facts which related to the sciatic nerve injury. As we all know, the sciatica, which is awkward due to the compression or some pain, which is result due to the sciatic nerve. And apart from sciatica, there is also certain sciatica nerve injuries. In that, we are going to see some of the injuries. The first thing, weak flexion of knee. This deformity occurs when there is a paralyzing of hamstring muscles. And second thing is about the foot drop. How the foot drop will occur? It occurs, this deformity, it occurs due to the paralyzing of extensors or the common peroneal nerve. As we all know, the branch is common peroneal nerve is one of the branch of a sciatic nerve, and it leads to some disease called foot drop. At this condition, foot will be in a plantar flexure position. And third thing we are going to see about the wasting of the calf muscle. It is also result due to the problems in the tibial nerve. And next thing we are going to see about a loss of Achilles tendon reflex. How Achilles tendon reflex will occur? It can be occurred due to the paralyzing of three important muscles. They are nothing but gastrocnemius, soleus and plantaris. We all know these three muscles, the paralyzing of three muscles, which result in the loss of Achilles tendon reflexes. And next thing is about the tropic ulcers. Tropic ulcers is results due to the paralyzing of the medial, lateral and plantar reflexes. So these are all the various sciatic nerve injuries like weak flexion of the knee and the foot drop, wasting of calf muscles, loss of Achilles tendon reflex and tropic ulcers. So these are all the injuries which related to the sciatic nerve apart from sciatica. And finally, we just come to the summary part. In summary, we are going to just quick recap of the sciatica. As we all know, sciatica is a low back pain which is gradually moved to the leg, and it occurs due to the compressions or pressure or irritation which is due to the sciatic nerve. And we also see about the sciatic nerve. It's one of the longest and the widest nerve in the body. And we see about the types of sciatica, that is the neurogenic sciatica and referred sciatica. And in causes, we see about the spinal causes and non-spinal causes. Out of all the causes, this important thing is about spondylolithesis, spinal stenosis, or the growth factor, or piriformis syndrome. These are all the important things we must have to know in the causes of sciatica. And we see about the risk factors, what are the conditions, and we see about the symptoms. In symptoms, very much peculiar, very much in this numbness or weakness or loss of the movements. And next we see about the treatment. In treatment, we have seen about the different parts like surgical treatment and the non-surgical treatment like minor discectomy, or it may be a spinal fusion, acupuncture, dry leaf, lots of things we have seen in the treatment. And we see about the clinical forms, and at last we see about the various causes or various injury apart from the sciatica. So these are all the overall view of the sciatica. I think we come to our last part. As you all know, I think I'm just clarify. I hope I will explain my topic in the sciatica in a very good manner. I hope everyone must understand and clarify. You will get some views or some points regarding to the sciatica. And I'm so happy to taking this topic in the sciatica. If you have any doubts regarding this, feel free to ask me. I hope I can manage to clear your doubts, because as a first year student, this platform is very much needed to me. As we all know, due to this pandemic COVID period, lots of persons are in a very different and very difficult situation. At this situation, I'm very much happy that I'm participate in any physio orientership contest to expose my talent to in front of all great people, and I'm very happy that I competed with great people in my own physiotherapy team. So thank you for giving me confidence or strength. There are great people, and I am very happy that I competed with the great people in my own physiotherapy. That I can prove myself to the world. So thank you once again. Lots of thank yous to everyone for the organizers. I hope I just explained my topic, and you all very much clear to the topic. And thank you for this wonderful opportunity. Thank you.